Are you taping? All right. I'm so glad you're here because Ryan Dunn is in full-blown shit-talk mode. The shit-talk-o-meter is at 80, and he's claiming that if we were at Iceland tomorrow, he would go off of this waterfall in a barrel when he already pussied out in the winter.
Dude, he is so drunk right now.
Dude, I'm not even drinking.
He's full of shit. He would say anything just to try to, like, impress somebody or something. Like, I'll go over there.
I'd do it anytime.
He talks so much shit, dude. Let's confront that.
If we were in Iceland tomorrow, would you do the waterfall?
Think about it before you say it.
Definitely.
All because of a bar argument, we're really going to Iceland.
It's so not a big deal, let's go there!
You're dipshit. Hey, I got
a message
tonight. Iceland.
What?
We're going right now.
Shut up.
I'm serious, look. Because all there is a mini TV with pornos in there and rather sleeping in the calm.
What the hell's going on?
We're going to Iceland.
We're going to Iceland?
Right now.
Right now?
We have about an hour or two. Here's Ryan at the bar last night.
Dude, I'll do it.
Tipping his own beer.
His own cup. You were so loaded last night.
Yeah. How did this whole idea start?
We were at the bar last night. I was talking about how we went to Iceland before, and it was like snowing out, it was pretty cold, but he was supposed to go down the waterfall then, and he was claiming it was like too cold and all this stuff. He's like, I'd do that thing in a heartbeat, that thing's pussy shit. Like, I'd do it. Well, why didn't you do it while I was there?
It was cold, I'll do it right now. If
it
I was there
cold,
right now,
he's gonna go off a waterfall and he's worried about it being cold? Ew.
It's Iceland.
You're just out there at the bar last night just bragging to everyone, like, I'd have done it, it was just too cold.
Like, dude, he probably never thought it would, the day would come. Like, when's the next time we'll be in Iceland? Yeah, I'll do that.
Can I go over tonight?
It's the very next day we're going to Iceland. He didn't even wait time at all. I didn't even think
we'd be here. A waterfall. We got a plane to catch.
Waterfall.
That's just his name now.
Me, motherfucking W.I.
You thought he'd get just bumming.
Contemplating his own fate, that's all.
I just can't wait till I get drunk again so I can at least understand what the hell I was talking about last night.
Where do you see the footage, dude? You seriously don't even remember?
Not really.
Dude, it was so mellow.
Look at the pink.
Hey, how about, hey, Captain, how about you knock it off with the turbulence up there, you prick?
I haven't tried to drink back here.
I've had enough of this bumping around all night. Just want to swallow some vodka.
The bus ride to the rental car. Hannah was just ripping the sickest farts on the bus. He had a Pittsburgh Pirates hat on and he looked so dirty. A mixture of like Hannah's red bushy hair coming out of the back with that Pittsburgh Pirates hat. He just looked so dirty.
He was ripping farts. They were just like, ew, man, come on. Jesus. Oh my God.
You know, I'm so sick of this stupid fart game you guys keep playing.
That was so fucking good. And then at the Blue Lagoon, we all had our shirts off. Frost just goes, Hannah, you're really letting yourself go, man.
Your dreams.
Dude, have some self-respect for God's sake. Like, skip a meal.
Don't hold back for Mother Goose, yeah. Where's the fucking golden egg? Yeah, who wants a dick pic? Who a dick? Stop.
No, stop.
Ray's shit is so funny. First he whines about it, and then he's like, I gotta do this now. And then when I look over and just see him, it looked like I was watching The Lion King, because he's just in the mountains, and he's just in there.
Man. Oh. Oh. Oh.
Why would he turn this way? Why would he turn this way to do it?
There was poo.
And what did you do with it?
I put it in that the rock hole thing that I found.
Wait, what did you put in the rock hole?
The toilet paper and the poop and all that.
Ooh!
Oh!
Oh,
man.
Oh my God.
Oh.
Dude, we have to cross a stream right now, and I'm not sure how deep it is, so I'm gonna go check it out.
Wow. It's water though deep.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
All right, what's the worst that could happen?
We could get stuck and have to fucking walk home.
But what do you think the chances are?
I think the 50-50 would fucking suck.
Yeah, I don't like those odds. I don't even know what the chances are, but I don't like the odds.
Dude, we've been driving so far, we can't just turn around.
I just realized if we get stuck in the middle, dude, it could be days without food. Like,
yeah, why would you even...
That's all Hannah cares about. I think it's the most shallow, right?
No, over to the right.
The right?
Right there.
Shallow, so you can where you can see the rocks?
Don't be a retard. Yeah, back up. Back the hell up. It's deeper in the middle. That's
we're
the deepest part.
Time here, back and going back and forth.
We
could have a stream. Then we could have turned around already.
Yeah, we got already been there. Don't
turn the
don't.
Fuck around and go back.
You pussies are faggots.
I admit it. I was wrong. Oh, I was wrong.
So we finally get through that river. We didn't know that we were going to roll up to 17 more rivers, get to the point where we're going through rivers, water gets on the engine, shorts out the engine, this thing's sputtering up a hill, we all actually had to get out of the van, push it up a hill.
I was like, fuck this shit, because I'm not trying to walk all the way to like, who the hell knows where. We were in the middle of nowhere. Like, if you ever say that, that is the middle of nowhere.
That was bad when no one.
No,
talked.
Dude, no!
Dude, this is crazy.
Dude, just film out to the right.
Oh my God. We're in a lake.
We're straight up in a lake, dude. What the hell was that?
That is fucked.
What the hell was that?
This is fucked.
We needed a barrel so bad, and, you know, you figure you're going to a whole country, like, finding a barrel is the least of your worries. For any of you who can go to Reykjavik and find a barrel, you deserve $20,000. It was the biggest mission in the world to find that barrel. Finally, we see some guys moving chemicals. We asked them where they got their barrel. We went to the plant where they manufactured the chemicals. We couldn't find anyone who worked there to buy a barrel. Bam's like, no, screw it, we're wasting too much time. Franz, I'm gonna steal this barrel. So Bam jumped the fence, ran in, dumped all the chemicals out of this barrel, capped it back off, threw it over the fence, and we actually took off and went to the waterfall. And again, this is another reason why I was sitting in the van being bummed, because everything was really coming together.
Run.
Dude, he just ran to a smaller rock than he is big.
What did he just do in the middle of nowhere? He's managing to cover nothing.
Dude, it just started pouring. This dude, oh, it's gotta be the worst shit ever. He's gotta feel so uncomfortable.
You know what the worst part is? It's pouring down rain on his toilet paper now.
Fungus.
Ew, there's fungus on his freaking toenails, man. That guy does not take care of himself.
It's not just like one part there, the whole thing.
You banked your whole face off that.
Ew, dude. Ew, get that thing out of here.
It looks so weird on him.
It's so nasty.
Dunn's feet look like hobbits.
They do look like hobbits. Hey, Dunn. Barrel time. I found it. I'm so proud of myself.
The leg jabber joker.
Come on, Fanta.
Not only did Ryan not want to do it, he had to walk like 4 miles up a mountain to not want to do it.
I don't know if he has an eye hole, but he has an a-hole.
Please fall. Oh God, please fall. Oh, you gotta fall. Oh, fall, fall, fall. Oh, Hannah, you gotta fucking fall.
When we got there and I looked at it, all I was thinking is, what did I get myself into? It was so much bigger than I remembered.
He conveniently picks the tallest fucking one.
And they're like, yep, this is it. This is one, right? I'm like, it's like, you are completely screwed, Ryan. Like, God, why does he say those things to get himself into that
dude,
stuff? Like,
it could go either way. It could go down the left side and it could be real smooth and it could make it, or you could go down the right side and there's just jagged rocks all the way down, and it all is determined right around there.
What the hell are you trying to impress going to Iceland when you could have just went to Pennsylvania and did the same thing? Then if Ryan Dunn gets killed over there, then what do you got to do?
It's showtime, fellas.
We're here live, but not for you by the time you see it. But today it is with Ryan Dunn. He's about to go over enormous falls in Iceland. Dangerous, yes. Deadly, maybe.
How nervous are you right now? I'm serious.
I literally think I'm going to die here in about 5 minutes. So I hope it's worth it. And enjoy.
Just hop in.
Hop in.
Hold this.
I sat in that barrel for 1 second, and I realized this is not going to happen.
Fuck this now.
What?
Dunn, what are you doing? Get in the fucking barrel.
What do you mean?
Dude, my knees are fucking crammed in this side. My back is crammed in this side. I touch anything. There's an eighth inch piece of plastic.
Go back down again.
There's an eighth inch piece of plastic.
Let me just see. Dunn, what is there to think about? This is what you do. Get in the fucking barrel.
No, you're not going. No. What are you doing?
No, I don't give a shit if you fucking bought a ticket to goddamn Iceland. I was fucking drunk.
When Dunn popped out of that barrel, just,
I'm not going to do it. No, F you guys. I'm not going to do it. Like, I seriously thought that was it. I was like, don't tell me we came all the way to Iceland for Dunn not to go over in the barrel.
Not doing it now. We fly all the way here and then he just gets mad and that's it.
Is he serious?
He's in this barrel like, claustrophobic. Like, bro, you're about to fly off of like a 40-foot waterfall. That's the least of your worries.
Dude, there's just rocks
right down at the bottom there.
Yeah, it's soft-ass water over there.
Yeah, but you're going to be like just tapping them on the way down.
Tapping them on the way down. I weigh 160 pounds. There's not going to be any tapping. There's going to be plummeting into jagged rocks. Sounds great when, you know, I'm drunk at the bar. Look, you're looking at 7 foot deep, nice water over there. Yes, it looks like a wonderful lagoon. Look right underneath this waterfall. I just looked down there. It looks like freaking hell itself. So what do you want to have?
Dude, this is sketchy as hell. I would never do it. I was laughing at Ryan so bad, and I kind of feel bad now, and like, I would never do it ever.
He's not doing it.
Is he serious?
He's not doing it.
And at that point, I realized that I'm just going to deal with the fact that I'm full of shit, and I'm not going to back myself up because I am super claustrophobic, and I was literally hyperventilating before I even went over the barrel.
I know that was the reason why we went there, but... You know, like, I was even scared. I was like, dude, good thing Ryan talked all this shit and it wasn't me last night. Because if I was the one that said that and then I was flown to Iceland to do that, I would just be so mad at myself and I'd probably quit drinking.
Basically, we let Ryan feel sorry for himself for about 10 minutes until he was able to strap on a set of balls and go for a second attempt.
So finally, he just gives up. He just gets in the barrel and he's like, all right, I'm gonna do it.
Just, let's do it. I'm sick and tired of sitting here all nervous. I just want to get something happening.
Are you ready?
Yeah, let's just do it.
All right, done. Second attempt.
I was actually surprised when we got done to get back in the barrel. You know, I really didn't think he was gonna go over.
Everyone was like, dude, as soon as he gets in the second time, just put the lid on and just go.
All right? Yeah. All right.
Once I was in the barrel the second time, I knew there was no turning back.
But everyone was like, all right, he's in. I thought, just go right then. Don't wait for anything. Just throw him down.
I hit that water so hard.
I helped Brandon push the barrel off. And once he landed, I literally ran so fast to the bottom and jumped into the water to help Rab get him out.
It's so fucking cold.
Come on,
I'm inside of that freaking barrel, hyperventilating to the point where I thought I was gonna have a heart attack. The first thing I wanted to do is get out of that barrel. Dunn was definitely panicked. Being in the barrel and having gone down a waterfall and you know, taking a blow to the head, he didn't know which way was up. He just knew that water was leaking in all around him.
You all right?
Fuck!
You alright?
I don't know. He almost knocked himself out. He should have knocked himself out. Jesus Christ, you gotta be a stupid idiot to do something like that.
Can you feel everything with your feet?
I just had to lay there for a few minutes to gather my thoughts until I stood up and realized that everything was intact, and then we could discuss what I just did.
That was so fucking sick, dude.
Mission accomplished. Finally came through for once. Well done, Rye.
Yeah, you were going down like this, and then when you hit the water, you like the whole barrel went completely underwater because you just hit it so hard.
All right, it's bad enough I'm in a barrel and I'm going over a waterfall, but why would Brandon throw me head first?
You went head first.
Yeah.
Just think of what he's doing in there, just like.
Was he naked?
Is that all your passport's wet?
I have so much wet money. My passport is soaked.
Sorry, man.
Thanks, Rake.
Yeah, this guy kept...
Pure Icelandic blood.
Oh. It's going on.
Got a little bit of Remy XO to celebrate.
the most random party on the face of the earth.
Yeah, that's you drink that, that's a fucking jacket.
Line up, everybody. There you go, Dunn.
Nice.
Fire down. Right,
three shots. Okay.
This is the end of it.
Iceland's over. We're going home. That means a sissy too. We'll have to bring him back. It's been a wonderful time. I'm sure we'll love to come again.
You turned into an Australian.